Okay, so our topic for today is about governor. So, malapit na eleksyon. So, iboto nyo kung sino ang tamang opisyal na iluluklok nyo sa upuan. So, governor. So, sa machinery, meron din tinatawag na governor. So, these are an example of a... These are examples of governors. Ito usually makikita mo sa mga sa barko. Okay? To function. So, to maintain the engine speed at the desired value by controlling the fuel injection. So, governor siya ang nag-govern or nag-control ng engine speed at the desired value. So, para makontrol mo yung engine speed, kailangan mo kontrolin yung fuel na binibigay mo sa engine. So, mas maraming fuel, mas mabilis yung ikot or takbo ng engine mo. And then, pag konti lang yung fuel, so, mas mabagal yung engine speed mo. Or, kung mabigat na yung engine mo, for example, meron kang generator, and then, yung generator mo ay isang bahay lang yung sinusuplaya ng energy. So, ganito lang yung fuel na kailangan niya. Pero pag limang bahay na yung binibigyan mo ng energy or ng electricity using your generator, so, pang limang beses din na fuel na yung ilalagay mo yun para makaya niya yung limang bahay na sinusuplayan mo ng kuryente. So, ganun yun. So, this is a typical diagram or simple diagram of a mechanical governor. So let's check the parts. So at the top, we have the speed adjustment, and then we have the spring, we have the flyweight, we have the rotating ball head, the gear wheel drive, we have at the bottom, we have the piston valve, the oil supply and oil drain, and then the power piston and the fuel control. So ito yung governor, and then yung fuel control naman is ito yung nakakonekta papunta sa ating mga fuel pumps, papunta sa fuel injector ng main engine. Okay? So that are the parts. So we will discuss more about this. So mechanical governor, they are speed sense the parts of the mechanical governor. We have the speed sensing portion, which is the ball head, the carrier flyweights on crank levers. We have the actuating portion. We have the the connection. So, ang connection natin is through linkage to the fuel pump racks. So, saan ba yung linkage na yon? So, yung linkage na yon is nakakonekta dito sa ating fuel control. Dito yung linkage na yon. Nakalink lahat ng fuel pump sa isang governor lang. Hindi yung limang fuel pump, limang governor din. Isang governor lang sa lahat ng fuel pump. Okay? So, setting. So, it depends upon the load torque. So, droop is the variation in engine speed following a load change. Approximately 4% for a full load change. So, ano yung load? For example, may generator ka, di ba? Yung generator natin is coupled or nakakonekta sa engine. So, yung engine natin, generator. And then, yung generator natin is, for example, nagpailaw ka ng limang bumbilya or ilaw. Nagpailaw ka. Limang ilaw sa bahay. And then, yun yung load. For example, nagdagdag ka ng electric fan. So, madadagdag din yung load na binibigay mo sa engine. So, yun yung ibig sabihin ng load. Or yung mga gumagamit or yung pampabigat sa engine, yung load na yon. Okay? So, hindi yung load sa cellphone. So, approximately 4% for a full load change. So, hydraulic governor. So, Woodward governor is commonly used on board. So, a hydraulic amplifier amplifies the governor signal to the fuel pump. The hydraulic pressure for the amplifier is delivered by the camshaft lubricating oil system. So, meron tayong mechanical governor, meron tayong hydraulic governor, And usually naman sa barko is electromechanical. Merong electronic, merong hydraulic, merong mechanical. So, combination din yung sa barko. So, the electronic governor is a combination of electrical and mechanical components. Speed sensing device, the magnetic pickup coil, the rectified voltage signal is used in conjunction with a set speed signal to operate a hydraulic unit. So, ano yung pickup coil? So, yung pickup coil is naka-connecta yon dun sa flywheel. Diba? Tatakbo yung engine. So, yung engine, pagtakbo ng engine, isi-sense niya kung gano'ng kabilis yung ikot ng makina or it is a speed sensing device. So, through magnetic pickup, so, every time na tatamaan yung magnetic conduction dun sa dulo ng coil, natamaan ng metal or ng sa may flywheel, so nagbibigay siya ng signal kung gaano kabilis na yung ikot ng engine mo. So then the fuel controls are moved in the appropriate direction to control the engine speed. So pag na-sense mo na yung engine speed mo, so titingnan niya kung mabilis ba siya or mabagal ba siya. So depende sa nakikita niyang speed, so i-adjust niya agad yung fuel control mo. So, remarks on failures and irregular operation. So, parts of governor. So, mayroon din tayong mga failures, pero yung failure sa governor is very minimal lang. So, kadalasan sa governor natin is tumatagal talaga siya hanggang sa sunod na maintenance ng mga technician. So, usually, hindi tayo marine engineers ang nag-maintain ng governor because it is a very sensitive equipment. So, kailangan din yung mga technician yung yung gagawa ng pag-maintenance dun. And then, meron din siyang mga special tools na technician lang ang meron, wala sa barko. Okay, failures. So, parts of governor jamming. Pump or non-return valve in governor is defective. The governor does not function properly, does not operate the regulating linkage, does not respond to load changes. So, has just undergone repairs, has tripped, is blocked, is cold. So, maraming possible failures sa governor. Pero, kadalasan is minimal lang na nangyari yan. So, 7 years kung pagbabarko, isang beses lang na parang nagloko yung governor namin. So, remarks on failures and irregular operation number 2. So, the governor is defective. Gear-driven hunting. So, ano yung hunting? Yung parang naghahabol siya sa speed. So, for example, bumilis yung takbo niya. So, automatic, magbabawas siya ng fuel. Pagkatapos, nung pagbawas naman niya ng fuel, nasobraan naman yung baba ng speed. So, magdadagdag naman siya ng fuel. So, pagdagdag niya ng fuel, nasobraan naman yung bilis ng takbo. So, parang hindi niya ma-meet yung set point o hindi niya mapaabot sa tamang speed. Nag-hunting-hunting lang siya sa speed niya. So, parang taas-baba. Parang parang naghahabol siya, nag-hunting siya sa kanyang set point. So, next, the governor is incorrectly adjusted. So, the governor is warm, operates irregularly, has picked up errors, incorrectly adjusted, and the governor sticks or dumidikit siya, hindi umiikot, hindi na gumagalaw. Okay. So, all marine vessels ranging from a huge cruise liner, big oil tanker, relatively smaller yacht, or even a tiny power boat need some sort of speed control system to control and govern the speed of the marine diesel engine or whatever propulsion plant is being used for the vessel. It would be really impractical and dangerous to have a ship or a boat without speed control mechanism fitted on it and could lead to accidents such as collision or grounding. So, the speed control, yan na ang governor natin. Okay, so we will focus here on the picture. Ito ba? Okay, clear ba? Okay, so these are activities na lang. Okay, let's focus here on the picture or the diagram of the governor. So this is a governor, so pwede ba natin palakihin pa to? Palakihin pa natin. Okay, wait lang. Okay. Okay, so this is a mechanical governor. So, so how do we start? So, the oil supply here is for lubrication. Okay, so we will focus first on the top. So, at the top, we can see a speed adjustment. So, itong speed adjustment natin is pwede mo ikutin ito para ma-adjust mo yung speed ng governor kung gano, ano yung gusto mong speed adjustment na gusto mo. Okay? So, this is just a parang screw yan na ikutin mo para ma-adjust mo yung speed. So, pag may, pag nasa barko naman, di naman yan ginagalaw. So, so yung i-discuss ngayon is purely for knowledge na lang. So, hindi naman yan ginagalaw sa barko. Okay, next, speed adjustment is nandito yung spring, meron tayong spring dito. So, paikot yan. So, parang bola lang sa side view. Pero paikot yan yung spring na yan. And then, may nakapatong na hindi nakalagay dito yung part na to. Nung name ng part na to. So, lagay. Meron nakapatong na parang metal yan. Then, spring. And then, meron tayong fly weight. Okay, so itong flyweight na yan, yan ay umiikot. So, it's rotating. I have a video about this. So, that mas makita nyo yung movement ng governor. So, we will look at it here. Nandito kaya yung kalimutan ko, meron pala akong video nito. So, mas madaling maintindihan pag sa video natin tinignan. Okay, video. Dito kaya yung video na yun. Videos. Governor. So, itong governor comments is ibang ibang type ng governor yan. So, yan yung usually ginagamit ng mga comments na generator. Governor. Okay, 7. Is this the governor? Okay, this is the video. So watch this video until the end. Wait, close my Bluetooth. Okay.
If a diesel engine is to be operated within a certain speed range and under varying loads, a mechanical device is required to control the amount of fuel injected. This device is called a governor. The speed of a diesel engine depends on two factors: the amount of fuel injected into the cylinders and the load under which the engine works. Suppose, for example, that the engine is running at a certain speed. If the load is increased, the engine slows down. If, on the other hand, the load should decrease, with no change in the amount of fuel injected, the engine speeds up. By regulating the amount of fuel injected, the engine speed may be kept within a certain range. To do this, various types of governors have been developed. Most governors operate on the principle of centrifugal force. Centrifugal force is the tendency of an object, when traveling in a circular path, to move away from its axis of rotation. These rotating weights are affected by this force. As the speed is increased, centrifugal force grows stronger, pushing the weights further away from their rotational axis.
So habang umiikot yung spindle sa gitna, so habang bumibilis yung ikot, yung ating dalawang bola or dalawang weights sa gilid is lumalayo din siya. So pag mabagal naman yung takbo, ikot, so nasa loob din yung balls or yung weights na yan.
The distance from this axis is proportional to the speed of rotation. One type of governor is the overspeed governor. It acts merely as a safety device and keeps the engine from overspeeding or racing. The basis of the overspeed governor is a pair of flyweights mounted on the drive shaft. The outward motion of the flyweights is transmitted to a collar which slides on the shaft. The movement of this collar actuates a linkage to the fuel pump controls. A spring presses upward against the collar. As the engine operates at normal speed, the flyweights tend to move outward. This movement, however, is retarded by the spring. But should the engine speed increase to a point where the safe speed limit is exceeded, the centrifugal force of the flyweights becomes great enough to depress the spring. This actuates the linkage to the fuel pump control, reducing the amount of fuel injected, and a decrease in engine speed results. Thus, the overspeed governor serves as a safety device in preventing the diesel engine from overspeeding. One design of overspeed governor, called the overspeed trip, is sometimes used to stop the engine completely when a safe speed is exceeded. This type of overspeed trip has only one flyweight, also working on the principle of centrifugal force. While the engine operates at a safe speed, the rotating flyweight is held close to the drive shaft by a spring. As soon as the engine overspeeds, the flyweight moves outward and trips a latch. This causes the fuel supply to the injection valves to be shut off, and the engine stops. Let us repeat the action of this mechanism step by step. The flyweight is held to the drive shaft by a spring. When the engine overspeeds, centrifugal force overcomes the resistance of this spring, and the flyweight moves away from the shaft. In this position, the rotating flyweight trips the latch, which releases the spring-loaded plunger. The plunger pushes against the fuel cutout lever, which in turn moves the fuel pump control to the no injection position, and the engine stops. Before the engine can be started again, the latch and the fuel pump must be reset. This is done by this reset arm, which is mounted on the reset lever shaft. The fuel cutout cam, mounted on the control shaft of the engine, is used when stopping the engine by hand. When the starting lever of the engine is moved to the stop position, the cam turns the cutout lever, shutting off the fuel pumps. The regulating governor not only keeps the engine from overspeeding, but maintains the engine speed at a fixed rate despite changes in load. In this governor, the flyweights are linked hydraulically to the fuel control assembly. This assembly consists basically of a piston connected to the fuel system controls, a housing, and a spring. The downward pressure of the spring is balanced by oil pressure on the lower side of the piston. The amount of oil in this space is regulated by a valve called the pilot valve, controlled by the flyweights. When the engine is running at a set speed, the port to the power cylinder is covered by the pilot valve plunger. The plunger is held in this position by the flyweights. If the engine load decreases, however, the engine speeds up, and the additional centrifugal force throws the flyweights outward, raising the pilot valve plunger. This opens the port, and oil from the power cylinder is now allowed to flow through the pilot valve cylinder into a drainage passage to the oil sump. The power spring forces the piston down, actuating the linkage to the fuel system controls, and the supply of fuel to the engine cylinders is diminished. As the engine speed returns to the set rate, the flyweights resume their original position, and the pilot valve plunger again covers the port. If the load increases, the engine slows down, and the flyweights move inward. This lowers the pilot valve plunger, allowing oil to flow through the pilot valve chamber to the power cylinder. This oil, supplied by a pump, is under a pressure sufficiently high to overcome the pressure of the power spring. The power piston moves upward, increasing the amount of fuel injected into the cylinders. Once again, as the speed returns to the set rate, the flyweights resume their central position. The gear pump, which supplies the high-pressure oil, is driven from the governor drive shaft and takes suction from the governor oil sump. A spring-loaded accumulator maintains a constant head of oil and allows excess oil to return to the sump. To increase the regulating governor's sensitivity and to prevent overcorrection, a compensating mechanism is used. This allows the pilot valve port to remain open just long enough for the engine speed to return to the set rate. A compensating plunger on the power piston shaft moves in a cylinder which is also filled with oil. When the engine speed increases and the power piston moves downward, the compensating plunger is also carried down, drawing oil from a cylinder below the pilot valve bushing. This creates a suction above the receiving compensating plunger, which is part of the bushing. The bushing moves upward, closing the port to the power piston. Thus, the power piston is stopped, allowing no time for overcorrection. As the flyweights and pilot valve return to their central position, oil flowing through a needle valve allows the compensating spring to return the pilot valve bushing to its central position. To keep the port closed, the bushing and plunger must descend at exactly the same speed. Therefore, the needle valve must be adjusted so that the oil passes through at the required rate for the particular engine. When the engine speed drops below the set rate, the actuating compensating plunger moves upward with the power piston. This increases the oil pressure above the receiving compensating plunger, which therefore moves down, carrying with it the pilot valve bushing. As before, the port leading to the power cylinder is closed. The excess oil in the compensating system now drains out through the needle valve as the spring returns the bushing to its central position. The governed speed of the engine is set by changing the tension of the speed-adjusting spring. The pressure of this spring determines the engine speed necessary for the flyweights to maintain their central position. Oil, allowed to leak past the various plungers for lubrication purposes, is drained into the governor oil sump. These are the basic elements of this type of regulating governor. In actual operation, the events which we have seen step by step take place almost simultaneously. Let us review the operation of the governor and maintaining the engine speed under a suddenly increased load. The engine speed drops and the fly weights move inward, lowering the pilot valve plunger. Oil from the gear pump and the accumulator forces the power piston upward, increasing the amount of fuel injected into the engine cylinders. In the meantime, the pilot valve bushing has moved downward, closing the port in the pilot valve. As the engine speed returns to normal, the fly weights and the pilot valve plunger and bushing return to their central position. Now, if the load suddenly decreases and the engine starts to race, the fly weights move outward, lifting the pilot valve plunger. Oil drains from the power cylinder, allowing the power piston to move the fuel control, decreasing the amount of fuel injected. In the meantime, the pilot valve bushing has moved upward, closing the port in the pilot valve. As the engine speed returns to normal, the fly weights and the plunger and bushing again resume their central position. Always keep the governor clean and keep it free from dirty lubricating oil. Flush it out every 2 weeks with clean fuel oil. Flush it out every 6 months with carbon tetrachloride. Refill it with lubricating oil of the viscosity specified by the operator's manual. Be sure that the oil is always at the proper level, keeping it above 5/8 of an inch in the gauge glass. Never tamper with the governor unless you are positive that there is some trouble with it. And even then, all repairs should be made only by an experienced operator.
Okay. I hope the video is clear. But this one, so pag mabilis yung ikot ng flyweight natin is lumalayo siya. So, ano ba ibig sabihin ng mabilis ang ikot? Ibig sabihin nung pag walang load, for example, nagpatay ka ng aircon. So, nagpatay ka ng aircon, so, yung engine mo, bibilis yung takbo kasi wala na siyang bigat na nakuha mula sa aircon na yon. So, lalayo itong flyweight. Pag lumayo yung flyweight, aangat tong spindle na to. And then, mag-a-adjust agad siya. Pag angat niya, magdadagdag agad siya ng babawas agad siya ng fuel doon sa ating fuel pump. And then, pag ito namang flyweight natin is bumagal yung takbo or bumigat yung engine mo and then nadagdagan ng load, so babagal yung takbo niya kasi mabigat na. So, pag mabagal yung takbo, yung flyweights mo papasok. Gaganon. Pag ganon, ano mangyari? Itutulak niya yung spindle na ito pababa. Pag tulak ng spindle na ito pababa, itong nandito sa fuel control is aangat, dadagdag siya ngayon ng fuel. So, ganun lang kasimple yung governor. I hope na hindi kayo nahirapan. So, if medyo nahirapan kayo or naguguluhan, so just adjust nyo, tingnan nyo lang sa video and then kahit ibagalan mo yung speed ng pag-play mo ng video para mas maintindihan mo lalo. So, ulit-ulitin mo lang yung pagtingin doon sa video na natin and then you will maintindihan mo lang talaga siya kahit sa isa, hindi sa isang beses mo makuha mo agad, pero at least makuha mo siya sa paulit-ulit na pag-watch mo nung video. So, if may iba ka pang tanong, simply message me or comment your question and then I will try to answer them. So thank you for your time. So see you again.